Hey guys, your boy Gerbers, and welcome back to my favorite 16 Liverpool promo where last time I left off. I beat Hull in the league, and I captured the Capital One Cup by beating Manchester City. So, two cities, these in the last episode, and one at the start of this episode, because my next game is Swansea City. So, facing all of the cities. E-based teams, apparently. Fair enough. Two for two. Let's go 3 for 3. Against City teams. Hull City, is it?
Liverpool getting it right at the back and building from that, building on the best defence.
And I think what makes this team so hard to beat is the fact that everybody works hard out of possession. It starts at the front with the strikers.
This is the Liverpool side. Nathaniel Clyne starts with Ricardo Rodriguez in the fullback positions.
Yeah.
Wide positions. Cristiano Ronaldo plays up front with
three things to talk about. This that happens in my last promo video. Like Arsenal signing in the side. Xhaka from Mönchengladbach.
Fantastic goal.
Arsenal fans. Big break it here, but this is probably gonna be the one side. One big sign that Wenger usually makes, like
that's
how he only made one sign last summer. And true, 30 million is more than I think anyone expected Wenger to spend on any kind of player. But yeah, I mean, 30 million, he should be sending that on a top quality striker. And, or on a center defender. And while, yes, Arsenal did lose central midfielder, so obviously they need to replace Arteta, who left. I think Fellaini. No, not Fellaini. Flamini. I think he left as well last season. In the last season, Arsenal fans can correct me if I'm wrong. Maybe he's still there. I think he left. His contract was up, and that's why Arteta left as well.
Nathaniel Clyne, Gareth Bale,
and also Liverpool may sign Lloris Karius from Mainz.
They set it up well for the cross.
Now, I find something interesting about this. Is according to stats I looked at, he was the second best goalkeeper in terms of stats in the whole Bundesliga behind Farman last season, this past season. He got a team of the season, as I'm sure some of you saw, those of you who play Ultimate Team, or saw. And we signed him for less than 5 million. And I'm like, brilliant. Well, I find even hilarious is my friend said to me that if Rodgers had made this signing, everyone would be saying he's signing a backup keeper, or he's not taking it seriously. But under Klopp, everyone is like, oh, we have a new number one. Not only did he give him the number one jersey, but he's from a team Klopp played for and managed, so Klopp will know everything about it. And I couldn't help but start to giggle because he's absolutely right. If Rodgers had signed Karius, everyone would be scratching their head, like, $5 million, spending a lot more on a keeper. But maybe Klopp sees something that we don't.
Delightful football from Liverpool today.
Ding. And Karius. Obviously, Karius is a very good goalkeeper, and Klopp sees that he can easily be better. $5 million might be a,
and it's now with Liverpool.
A bit of daylight robbery. I mean, you consider how little Arsenal paid for Cech. They got him from a Premier League rival in Chelsea. And Karius won't take as long as normal with foreign players to get used to the Premier League because he used to play in the Premier League. Well, I don't think he ever played for them, but he was. He came up through the ranks of Manchester City. Isn't that massively convenient? So he'll already know a bit of English-ish.
Take the chance with the shot there.
Yeah, thought he might have done better there. Had a bit of time and space. Good position.
He's already spoke in the club. He said he had a good talk with it. So all signs are pointing to it being a good signing. But what didn't make me laugh was that my friend is absolutely right. If Rodgers had made this signing, we'd all be scratching our heads, wondering if he was playing with a full deck. Or if he had gone absolutely off the edge.
Nathaniel Clyne.
But the kind of player Rodgers signs is Mignolet. And, sorry Celtic fans, you can look forward to him probably bringing in players like Mignolet to your team. Although, Mignolet would probably do well in this SPL. Because, like, although Rangers will be back, so it won't be all one-sided next season.
Coming up, a corner.
Hopefully. I mean,
goes for the volley. Here we'll see what they can manage from the corner.
Everyone who watches the SPL always says the same thing. It's not been the same since.
We've got his fist to it.
Since Rangers got demoted. So yeah.
Coming up for you, of course, on EA Sports, the presentation of the Barclays Premier League fixture. Swansea City, they'll be hosting Hull City.
Yeah, a lot of people have been talking about this one. Looking forward to it.
Wait. What was that? Brain, you're getting too confident with yourself.
And, some looks of disgust from teammates.
Penalty. Ref!
Nathan Dyer.
What is this bullshit?
Nathaniel Clyne.
Royce. Oh, great tackle by the Swansea defender. Key. Great tackle by Rodriguez. Clyne. Fail.
Looking to supply Cristiano Ronaldo. He's won possession.
Ronaldo. Sir Neymar. Your man almost scored an own goal. What the hell?
Afetimbi Gomis. Nathan Dyer.
Loses it. Go. Oh, go, 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 go. Loses to Ronaldo. How did you lose that, Cristiano?
Absolutely no trouble for the goalkeeper here.
Oh, I bet earlier in the week, I bet Real Madrid fans got the a fright of their life because Ronaldo, he left the training session early due to injury. I bet every Real Madrid fan was shitting their pants that he might miss the final. But it's only a dead leg, so chances are he'll miss the final. I don't think even if he was injured, he would miss the Champions League final. Not the chance to get his third Champions League winner's medal to tie again with Messi. Messi has won 3 times with Barcelona. Ronaldo went once with Manchester in 08, went 2 years ago with Real Madrid. Of course, La Decima. So, yeah. And plus, if he gets to Champions League, you can bet everyone's going to start kissing his ass and he's going to win Ballon d'Or again. Everyone's going to forget Messi's way better.
Good tackle. Timby Gomez. The shot's up!
Block it, block it, block it. Must keep clean sheet. Yes! 3-0. I will take it. I will take it. 3-0. Fantastic win.
One team to dominate the football. It was a football lesson. It was pretty humiliating for him.
Very good performance from my center backs, who both got goals, along with Coutinho. Look at Arsenal torturing poor Newcastle. Yeah, they do got they have enough things on their hands, Arsenal. Shame on you. Yeah, no. Italy. Nope. Not interested in being the manager of anyone. Here we go, the fourth game in the group stage. All I need to do is win, and I am guaranteed my progression to the knockout stage. This is Champions League. But to be fair, considering I'm 5 points ahead of both Marseille and Seville, it's pretty likely I'm going through. I mean, I'd have to lose all 3 of my remaining games. Has a ban, huh? When did he put that up? Hello, ban. Oops, no, don't put. Oh. Sensitive. Here we go. Fixed. Well, Orban, there's a chance you didn't think... Well, I didn't think you'd get a chance to... put your name in the shop window. Well, it's already in the window, but... a good performance and someone might actually buy you. Oh, I remember now. Soul guy yelled hard. He must have already been on one. I remember complaining about the yellow card. It was given very softly.
He could be the star turn for Liverpool today.
Well, he's a crowd pleaser because when he gets the ball, you just don't know what's going to happen. So many possibilities with him in possession.
This is the Liverpool side. Just to check on the formation. 4-4-2, but an interesting variation on it, Alan.
Yeah, a little diamond in midfield, and I wouldn't be surprised at some point. If it's not working, he'll go to a more conventional
Sanchez, who's celebrating his new contract.
I want to keep the opposition penned back. This throw can help do that.
And Nacho.
Powerful clearance. Well, that has cost them, but only a corner.
Origi's pressure leads to the corner.
Divo Origi. This could be danger with this.
Top. Oof. That would have been if he had somehow scored from that, that would have been his first goal since joining Liverpool.
Goalkeeper can get the ball here for his goal.
Terry couldn't keep it in.
He's crossed it well. Good take by the goalkeeper, but no pressure on him.
He got it. It's Terry. Oh, that's a naughty foul. Nothing! Really? No, even advantage being played. That wasn't a foul whatsoever. Is this the same referee of the Europa League final? Or by chance?
And in the wing area now can maybe attack.
This is shocking. How did he not give that? The guy didn't win the ball. He did. He got nothing by Kirby. It wasn't even a foul to this idiot. Yes. Iheanacho. Well, breaks the deadlock. Makes me feel a little better, but. That is still bullshit. I implore you guys, go back, watch that foul again. Tell me that I'm wrong. Tell me I'm wrong. He didn't... Cause I know he didn't give an advantage because the little thing didn't come up in the corner. He didn't give a foul at all. Oh, but you give a foul for that? Fuck off, you blue shirt wearing cunt. And I'll get you a white shirt because it's clear what... Team, you're here to support, you daft tit.
Yeah, really looking forward to this one. I think we're going to see some good football.
Oh, he's beaten his marker. Oh, in goes the cross. The goalkeeper comes out with a punch.
Hammering.
Well, it wasn't the most powerful header, so it was a very straightforward save.
Yeah, he didn't quite get the timing in that header. It's a weak effort.
Riggy. Make a run and cost that. Yes, Iheanacho. How did the keeper save that?
He adds to the catalogue of great moments he's had in this game. At the moment,
I don't even know.
Quite good. They would have hoped to be in a strong
get back down. Costa.
As we look towards the clock and half-time.
Riggy.
Oh, saved by the goal.
Costa. Oh, the keeper makes a huge error. What in the name of God was he doing? He must have money on Liverpool to win. He could have easily got that. Instead, he palms it pretty much to the foot of Martin Costa. I don't know if that technically counts as a traditional 1-2. Maybe it's an untraditional one. Well, all I know is it's 2-0. Well, and despite the referee being a dumb asshole, well, my progression to the knockout stage of the Champions League is pretty much touching my hands. Because these guys, they need to score 3 goals.
Origi. Here's the shot. A well saved.
Oh, great save. Their keeper is keeping them in this, to be honest. Oh, fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you.
Jurgensen. And the referee.
Oh, hi.
We saw from the first half, Alan, that the Tides really have got down to their style of play in this group. In now to the second half of their fourth match.
I'm going to look back on this episode and before I start this match, I'll see what the name of this referee is, so he can make sure that he never refs another one of my matches. I normally don't like to mess with the game. We ain't in the game. Anyway, let's do, unless it's changing the difficulty, because obviously the game doesn't come and automatically be put on in Legendary. You have to set your difficulty. But I am never having this guy referee me again. Not for that bullshit. Riggy! Oh, come on!
Jurgensen.
Chan. Hi. Ta. This is the ball! Hey, wins it back! It's fouled! Thank you! Who? Maybe he just didn't see it? No.
He can't keep it on the pitch, it's gone out for a throw.
Hard to miss someone trying to break my legs. No. I can understand how you'd miss something like that. It's pretty easy.
With Liverpool.
Really, Mattia? I don't need you against me, too. The tackle didn't go as planned.
And in goes the cross.
Get rid of it. Get rid of it! Brilliant!
Because now, still got a chance.
Well, they have. It was a sloppy one to concede from the opposition's point of view, and they've given the other team now a real chance. Well, I've always been an admirer of good headers, and this was certainly one of those, a thumping effort.
Now, you're
getting super pissed off now.
Now, here is a chance.
Yo, where's all this pressure coming from? It's gonna be red. I'm gonna take Costa off. I'm gonna bring on Gomez as an extra center back because I'm pretty much guaranteed. Yeah, I think it's probably one of my hitbacks is off. Chat, sit there. Okay.
And that will be.
Yes, the skate out. Yeah, what a surprise! You know it was an obvious red. This guy probably would have given a red anyway.
If they can defend with a bit of.
I don't know, one of my guys can play right back. Ox Gomez.
Intelligence, they might have a good chance.
Substitution for Liverpool. Goalkeeper hangs on.
I need to get another goal before this at the end of the match, just to kill off any hopes they have of snatching a draw. Come on, Ash. Yes! That's why they like to say good and on your way, Iheanacho. Oh, Origi just randomly standing on Iheanacho's arm. But yes, thank you, Kalichi Iheanacho. You are a boss.
3-1 it is now, the scorer.
Oops. Don't tell me that's another red. Shocking.
It is Liverpool's day, it seems. Barring any late slip-ups, they have been the team in control.
Nacho wins the ball and then just randomly punts it away.
The referee's decision, 2 added minutes. He's gone and won the ball with a very good tackle.
The Rivetar, thank you. 3-1. I am through to the knockout stage of the Champions League. Thank God that's over. How did your match go? 1-1. So I topped the group as well. Brilliant. Because they were 5 points behind me. They lost 2 points each. That's 8. That's 7. 3 would be 8. So angry. I just want to go. Oh, just calm down. Well, luckily, it's in the episode, so I can, in fact, do that. So thanks for watching, I hope you enjoyed, smash the like button if you did, subscribe for more videos very soon, and until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day.